Hi Alex, how are you doing?
Hey Mitch, I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm good. So we're here to talk about package management.
Yes, we are. What are you going to show us today, Mitch?
So I'm going to show you the basics of package management. I'm going to show you how to build a package and publish it and then consume it within another project.
Sounds exciting. Let's get started.
Fantastic. Okay, so what I've got on the screen here is a really simple class library. Just a little bit of code here. The code itself isn't that important. And what I want to do is share this code with other people within my organization. This is a really cool library that I want to share. So we've got this code up in version control, and we can actually now go and build that code on VSTS using the CI services. And we're going to publish the package from that CI build.
Makes sense. And you'll show us how to do that, hopefully.
I will. So I've got here a tab in Edge. You can see here that I've got a build definition called cycle service framework. And within that that build definition, I've got a couple of tasks that run. So I restore some packages. This code consumes some other packages. And then I run a build, and then I copy some files. But what's missing from this is the task that uploads the packages that I'm producing into package management.
Great. And so tell me more, like why would we want to share this package? What are we doing right now?
So one of the really important things about developing software is that you can try and reduce the amount of rework that you're doing. So ideally, you want to reuse code as much as possible.
Absolutely.
And package management allows you to do that.
Awesome. Yeah, let's see.
Okay. So what we want to do is we want to add a NuGet task. I'm going to be sharing a NuGet package, which is some reusable .NET code. And so I click the Add button here on my phase, and I search for NuGet, because we've got lots of tasks within VSTS. And I click Add on the NuGet task. And you can see here that I've got a NuGet restore task. If I click on that, there are some options. So there's lots of different things I can do here. I can restore packages, I can pack packages, or I can push packages. I want to push a package to package management. And I've actually got a package management feed within VSTS, and we'll look at that in a little bit more detail later on.
All right.
But really, all I need to say is I want to publish this package to the AdventureWorks feed. And I'm going to do this after I copy some files into an artifact staging directory. So I'm just changing the order of this task here.
Great. Now, so how do we create this NuGet package? How do we have this thing to publish?
Sure. So this code base that I'm working with is .NET Core. So every platform has its own way of packaging code. Mm-hmm. This is a .NET Core project. And so we're using MS Build to build the code base.
Great. And that's just going to make a package for us automatically, right? That's one of the great improvements of kind of using .NET Core.
That's right, yeah. .NET Core is definitely built around sharing and reusing packages. To make this work within VSTS, we specifically tell it to do the pack target. And you can see here, I'm actually also passing in the package version, because every single time I do a build, I want to produce a new version of the package.
Great. And you've done something really cool there. You're using just the build ID as a way to kind of increment constantly and have a version that's always changing.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, I'm cheating a little bit here. I might skip a few build numbers here, but depending on what you're doing, you might have different ways of doing versioning in your own projects.
Absolutely.
But this guarantees that I'll get a unique build number each time.
Yeah, and I think we even have some other videos out there for maybe further watching.
That's right. Fantastic.
All right, let's run a build.
Cool. So now I've got that all set up. So now I'm just going to save and queue that build. And I'm going to drop in and I'm going to look at this build. We can see it running. And just while we're waiting for that to kick off, you'll just notice up in the URL bar here that we've got the build ID is 248. So remember in the build definition, I was using the build ID for the package version?
I do.
Okay, so that build ID is what's going to be the patch version for this package once this build finishes.
Great, and so we're using semantic versioning for that, right? That's kind of NuGet's standard.
That's right. So .NET Core specifically uses semantic versioning. This is definitely a patch on the previous version.
Makes sense. And I mean, I think if you in the audience want to learn more about semantic versioning, semver.org is the place to do that.
Fantastic. That's good advice.
All right, so it looks like this build's going to run. We're using one of our hosted agents, so this is all happening in the cloud. This is in Azure, not anything that we had to spin up our own VM for. It brings Visual Studio, everything just along for the ride, right?
That's right. So this won't take long to complete at all. We're just restoring the packages. The build won't take long, and publishing the packages won't take long. And once that's done, we can jump across to package management.
Perfect.
So here's a completed build that I did previously. And so The build's complete, and you can see that the push command completed successfully.
Makes sense.
And so now I can jump across to the package management feed. And so inside package management, we have this model where we've got multiple feeds within a particular team project.
Sure. And can I think of a feed maybe as like a repository for binaries almost?
Exactly, exactly. Great. And so we call it a feed, but yeah, it's kind of like a repository for any kind of artifact. And in this case, we're dealing with a NuGet package.
Got it.
And so if I click on the cycle services package, which is the one that I just published, you can see that I have some metadata about that package. And then I can go and look at all of the different versions of that package.
Looks now, like we've got some old versions hanging out in there.
We do, we do. So we jumped from 101 to 10247, and we'll have a new package version coming in very soon. Now, if I want to consume this package inside another project, what I do is I use the connect to feed button.
I see, and that's how I tell like my Visual Studio or my NuGet or .NET where this feed is, right?
That's right. So if I click on that, it gives me all of the information I need to use that. To access that package. And you can see this URL here is the URL to the package index that NuGet needs.
So this is almost like my own personal version of NuGet.org.
That's right. Yeah, it's great for private repositories. And so I can copy that URL, and if I jump back into Visual Studio, I have another project where I want to use this particular library. And so I would go and I would click on the Manage NuGet Packages option on the project, and you can see here that I've already got a private package source set up, but I'll just show you that that private package source just points to that package feed, which I just copied out of the browser.
Got
so that's
it.
Already set up. Now once I've done that, I can actually browse the package feed and I can search for the package that I'm interested in. This feed only has the one package, so we're just going to pick that and we're going to install that.
And it looks like I see that 2.4.8 version, so that build
that's
completed.
Right. That's right. Yeah,
the demo gods are smiling on us
that's
today.
That's right. It just caught up. And so NuGet will do its thing. It'll pop up and confirm that I want to install this package. And
makes
I click
sense.
OK. OK. And so now that that's done, you'll see that in the packages list for this particular API that we have a cycle services 2.4.8. And if everything's working correctly, I should be able to compile that code. Nothing's broken. Whoops, I've got to fix some code here. You can see here that I have an action on a controller where I've got some commented out code. That code points to a class inside that library that I've just consumed. And if I compile my code again, that will work fine and my code base will work if I run it.
Great. And so crisply, just kind of summing up what you've shown here, I've now have two separate projects. Maybe I have a shared API, something that one team in my organization makes and wants to share and have reusable, and now you've kind of enabled all the other teams to consume that just by connecting to my package feed.
That's right, that's right.
Awesome.
And we should see the result there on the screen. There we go, there's my, that little
looks like our API work has a little more work to go.
That's
maybe
right.
We should make it a little more than a demo package.
That's right, but that's working the way it's expected to work at the moment.
Awesome. So. And I mean, I think the key theme here is we showed you just in 5 to 7 minutes just how easy it is to get started with package management.
That's right. It's quite straightforward, and we support not just NuGet, but we support NPM and Maven as well.
That's right. So whether you're doing JavaScript development, if you're a Java developer, if you're a .NET developer, then we kind of have full support for that.
We've got you covered.
Right, right. And we support that in our hosted builds too.
Yep, that's right. We see a lot of people sharing packages. It's a great way of increasing the level of reuse across your organization.
Absolutely. And it means I get to focus on my unique value instead of writing that code for the 20th time.
That's right.
Everyone likes that.
Great.
Alrighty.
So thanks for joining us, and Alex, thanks for coming along and being my wingman on this. And
always happy to help.
Fantastic.
All right, thanks, guys.
Bye.